too much. Folks, somebody say this God is just too much, too much. Hallelujah, it's too much. Listen, listen, listen. I'm here to tell you that there is nothing God cannot do. There is nothing. January this year, I was home with the girls, and I don't know what we were doing. All of a sudden, I felt this very sharp pain on this side of my body, and it was so severe that, you know, for hours, it kept going on and on and on and on until I could no longer take it. So I was rushed to the emergency. I was rushed to the hospital. When we got there, they did all necessary scan and everything. And then they said, you know what, you've got a gallstone. So go see your family doctor. They gave me some painkiller. Go see your family doctor and then we'll take it from there. So the next day I went to see my family doctor. My family doctor said, well, I need to refer you to a surgeon. So I went to see a surgeon with my husband, and the surgeon looked at me and he said, your gallbladder is filled up to the brim with stone. He said, I'm afraid you may go into, and I said, we need to perform an emergency surgery on you. Take out your gallbladder. And I said, why must you take out the gallbladder? The stone is a stranger. Take out the stone and leave the gallbladder. He said, no, we need to take out your gallbladder. That's how we do it. I said, no, you need to take out the stone and leave the gallbladder. So we went on and on. And he said, well, the only thing I'm afraid of is, you know, if you eat anything that is oily, you may go into, we may have to perform an emergency surgery on you because the stone will travel all the way. All the medical people in the house, you know what I'm talking about. Travel all the way and then it could lead to some complication, you know. Put a lot of things down that, you know, myself and my husband, he was there. He kept on saying, just listen to what they are saying. But I kept on arguing, saying, no, take out the stone, leave the gobbler. Anyway, I said, give me some time, let me just go. So I went home, we prayed together. Deep in my spirit, I felt it that, you know, God didn't want me to take out my gobbler. But so my gallbladder said, no, the stone was good, the gallbladder was remain. So I went on and on and on. It was one, you know, emergency rush to the ER by my husband, you know. I will go there and then he will, you know, kind of give me some things to relieve the pain, and then I'll come back home again. So I took out all oil, everything from my food. I stopped taking anything that has oil. No stew, no swallow, nothing. All I was feeding on was vegetable and, you know, the rest. And I kept on saying, God, do you really want me? God kept on telling me, no, I'm going to heal you. So I started praying alongside with my husband, believing the Lord. I took some of our bread. I said, pray for me. I'm not going to do any surgery. I'm standing on the word of God. The more I prayed, the more the pain became very severe. And you know, fear will come, then I'll counter it with faith and say, no, 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 no. The Bible says strangers will run out of their secret places. I said, the stone is a stranger, the gallbladder is not a stranger. So after 3 months, I went back to the doctor. I said, can I have another ultrasound done? I said, because I'm trusting the Lord and my healing is perfected. The doctor said, okay, if you want to have another one done, you go do it. Anyway, she put everything in the requisition and I went. When I went for the second one and I did the test, it showed the difference between the first one and the second one. The first one was 10 centimeters stone, 10 centimeters gallbladder filled with stone. By the time we did the second test, it said 2 centimeters. It said, no, 5 centimeters.
You are not an engineer. The first one was 2 centimeters in diameter. Now, the second ultrasound showed 0.5.
Hallelujah.
So it has gone down from 2 centimeters to 0.5 centimeters. So we knew God was working.
Yeah.
So then I started, you know, I said, yeah, that's really good, you know. And I remember there was a particular day, all through the night, I couldn't sleep. I was right on the floor, my husband was praying for me. It was Sunday morning. And that Sunday morning, he left me at home and he went to church, you know, very early in the morning. And I got a call from somebody in this church, a sister in the church, who was also in pain. I was actually bleeding as a result of a pregnancy. And my phone was close to me. I picked the phone and I listened to her and she was like, mommy, mommy, I'm in pain. And I wanted to say, look, I'm in pain. You know, but all of a sudden I just said, God, give me the strength to just support this sister in this moment. So I pushed my pain aside and I started praying for her. She had no clue what I was going through. I didn't sleep all through the night. And when I finished that prayer, God told me, God said, because you push your pain aside and you attended to the pain of another person, this stone is no longer an issue for you. You know, and I believe God, I know how I got down to the word of the Lord. To cut the long story short, this last Friday before we traveled, because I wanted to eat steak, I wanted to eat everything human being eats. So I told my doctor, I said, can I have another ultrasound done on Friday on this? So they booked me for this last Friday before we traveled. And I went there, did the ultrasound, and went back to the office. By 11 o'clock, 3 hours or 4 hours there about later, I got a call from my doctor. The first thing she said, and when doctor call you themselves, instead of making the nurse to call you, just know that something is up. So when I saw the call, I'm like, oh my God, what is going on? And she said, what did you do to your stones? I said, what did I do with my stones? I said, so what exactly are you talking about? He said, we looked for it. There was no more stone in your gallbladder. You are free and completely.
You love your wife, you are in greater pain as a husband. It was tough. As much as that pain was on, when a member of church is pained, we leave our pain aside. Even in pain, she was praying for somebody else. We cover our pain up. You know what God said? Because my people are pained, I am pained. So when you are pained, God is pained. And we give God all the glory. Yes. There are two items in that testimony she skipped. Number one, we woke up one morning and she had a dream where he saw stones on the floor. Right? She woke up and said she saw some stones on the floor in the dream. And she was asking that figure, and I know it's Jesus. He said, what are those stones? He said, those are the stones. Your gallbladder. It was at that point that I knew God has finished the work. Now, one other thing that she skipped again was the fact that when we went to see the doctor and we were saying, why don't you remove the stone and leave the gallbladder? He said, what is the gallbladder doing anyway? He said, what is the gallbladder there for anyway? I said, what? That was where I got angry. God opened the gallbladder there. I know there are people who are without gallbladder. It's okay. He said, what is the gallbladder doing there? Anyway, I got angry in my spirit. I said, if there's no need for gallbladder, God won't put it there. That was where I said, no. This is an affront on God. That was the beginning of our journey to this testimony. Father, we thank you.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name.
Amen.